going on, veterans? JB coming to you live. I want to share with you guys some back office stuff that goes on with the business of getting you guys service connected and a service connection at a high value. It takes a lot of work to, first of all, assemble a network of doctors to go to work for you. But not only that, like I said, you got to put yourself in the mind frame of that particular physician. We're asking a physician to open their practice up for scrutiny by the VA about your claim. They run audit checks all the time when it comes to these physicians making these opinion letters. Have they reviewed your medical records? Have they looked at all this stuff? So don't think just because, you know, I may sound cool and, you know, down to earth, which I am, by the way, but don't think for one moment that these doctors, the reason why they don't want to help you in your state, in your local municipality, is because they know the backlash they're going to receive from the VA. And I know you're probably saying, man, is that just, that's just crazy. We fought for this country. You know, we wore the uniform of the greatest country in the world. We fought for everyone's freedom, including our own. But when we come back from serving, we got a whole list of things we have to deal with, the bureaucracy, the political filibustering when it comes to thanking the veteran for their service. And it's great to say thank you for your service, but really, are you really thanking me for my service when the veteran is left on their own to provide the evidence, the proof, and the scrutiny to go beyond a reasonable doubt that you got an injury from the military? It's not enough to have a diagnosis. It's not enough to show in-service, a pre-service, or after-service event. It's not enough to have a medical nexus letter with the medical rationale. It's not enough to have a DBQ. It's not enough to have lay statements. When you think about, they go behind your back and go to the physicians and scrutinize them, put them through an audit process behind an office visit about you and your claim. So if you want to know the secret why you can't get most doctors to work on your behalf, they don't want the smoke, ladies and gentlemen. They don't want the smoke of the VA, the bureaucracy of the Senate, the VA committee. The Senate House Committee of the VA comes down the pipe to the directors, the quality assurance departments, to come down on these doctors who are writing these nexus letters to win those claims. That's the reason why you have so many veterans who give up, and there's so many veterans that have low ball claims. But I can assure you this, as you enroll into the New Life Insider program, I am going to guarantee you top-notch service. I'm going to guarantee that doctor is going to scrutinize you to make sure that you are suffering from these illnesses, and that if they want to do an audit, you're going to be okay, okay? And I do all of that for you, the recruitment of the physicians, the training of the physicians. I just left one of my physicians' office right now on that. So just know that the money that you're spending to enroll into the New Life Insider program is well worth it. And if we do change our rate, it's because there's more scrutiny, more things that we have to do to get it done for you, okay? So with that being said, I just want to let you guys know that it is not easy on my behalf to convince physicians in the Southeast region, let alone what you're trying to do with one doctor, but I have to convince multiple doctors, and I have to keep those relationships, and I have to keep training them and keep going seeing them on behalf of you as a veteran. I care about you guys so much that I want you guys to get a high value claim. I don't want to be the only person out here saying, you know, I got a high value claim. I got mine. You got to go get yours. Being selfish, there are a lot of veterans out there that complain or because nobody would help them go through the process, because it's a lot of stuff. There's a lot of factors that involve you getting a high value claim. It's almost counterproductive if you ask me, You know, the veteran, you know, administration always talks about the numbers of what the people they're helping get service connected, the amount of budgets or money, billions of dollars that they're spending each and every year helping our veterans. But they're again, they're changing the caregiver program. They're again, they're changing, getting ready to change the sleep apnea requirement for disability. They're getting ready to change the tinnitus requirement for tinnitus claims. They're getting ready to change mental health claims. You know, we're at the mercy of Congress when it comes to injured veterans, okay? I want you to understand is that, you know, you got the bureaucracy, not only from a political standpoint, from a congressional standpoint, but you have the bureaucracy from a leadership standpoint in the VA. There's 57 regional offices around the country that get it from the top, as you would say, as shit rolls down the hill. And they have these numbers that they have to hit, so many cases per day, down to the VA rater, have to go through 25, 30 cases per day. And regardless of whether or not they get them service connected or not, you're dealing with bureaucracy, which I call bullshit, and you're dealing with scrutiny of the doctors. There's so many factors that are against you as the veteran. There's no reason why veterans are giving up. Veterans are just throwing in the towel, and they're giving up on them getting a high value claim and coverage for their families. But I can guarantee you this, I'm fighting the fight for you guys as a veteran advocate. I could never want to work for the VA in the adjudication process. I would never want to be a VA raider or anything like that, because really I'm not doing you a justice being an employee. I can't work anyway because I can't be around that, you know, due to my PTSD. But I want you guys to understand the reasons why New Life Veterans exist, to help you as the veteran, to help you get a high-value claim. And I want you to understand the reason why we're still recruiting more physicians for you. We're still training. It's an ongoing process. Our fee is what our fee is. If you can't afford it, you need to go and afford it. There's no such thing as you can't afford it. You can't afford not to get compensated. You cannot afford to not to get compensated at a high value claim. There's not an American out there that can earn income without taxation. Okay? We're talking about tax-free compensation for the rest of your life and being increased every January, cost of living allowance. Not even having to do with anything dealing with Social Security. We are talking about real benefits for housing, tax-wise, property taxes, sales tax on vehicles. The list goes on. I would be willing to give almost my right arm to get service connected. And I would love, I wished that I had a service like New Life Veterans. Give me a like, give me a share, give me a comment, tell me what you think. If you like New Life Veterans, if you love New Life Veterans, let me know what we're doing for you. If you've gotten results from New Life Veterans, the Insider Program, let me know below in the comments. We appreciate you. And if you need a free consultation, all you got to do is log on to newlifeveterans.com. And New Life Veterans, just above this video, you see my, the way I spell New Life Veterans is N-U space L-I-F-E. veterans.com. Log on today to get a free consultation, and I can't wait to talk to you. God bless.